Hi there and welcome to another video from Hegarty Maths. It's Mr. Hegarty here, and in this video we're talking about writing algebraic expressions, our first video on that topic. So let's start as we always do by thinking about what we already know. Now you know that 2 add 3 is 5, that's easy. How would you show me that addition is what's called commutative with the statement 2 add 3? Well, hopefully you would say, well, that's the same thing as 3 add 2. And that would be a specific example of the fact that addition is what we call commutative. Addition is commutative. Now, if you were trying to explain that addition was commutative and you said, well, 2 add 3 is 3 add 2, someone might say, well, does it work with 7 and 5? And does it work with negative 3 add negative 2? And you would have to then say, yeah, it does. Let me write a couple more examples for you so you know it works in different cases. Or what we're moving into now is the world of algebra. You could use algebra to what's called write a generalized or more abstract statement of that fact you know about numbers. So let's have a go at that. Let's have a go at writing a generalized or abstract statement of the fact we already know that addition is commutative. What you could say is you could say, take any number you want, let me give it a name, let me call it X. Because I don't want to specifically give a number, because otherwise you might think it only works for that number. So let's take any number, X. I'm going to add to it another number, any number you want, I might call it Y. And I'm going to tell you that it always gives the same answer as Y add X, like that. And that there is using algebra to make a generalized or abstract statement of addition being commutative. And it's much, much more useful to us than a specific example. In a specific example, you may think it's something special about the numbers 2 and 3 that make it the same as 3 and 2. But in this case here, you know, well, I can choose any number I want. It could be a negative, it could be a fraction, it could be a whole number, it could be a decimal. And I'll choose any other number for this, and I know that I can swap the order round of addition. And that's the point of algebra, guys. Algebra is to allow us to make more generalized or abstract statements about things we already know about arithmetic and simple numbers. Let me give you another example. If you're a master in your indices, which you should be if you've worked through your number strand, you know that 27 to the power of 0 would be 1. But someone might say, well, is that something special about the number 27? Is only 27 to the 0 1? No. So you would write a more generalized or abstract statement using algebra and say, any number, I can call it X, I can call it Y, let me call it, I don't know, something different, A, to the power of 0 is 1. And that's a much more useful statement to us, because we know that I can have any number in there instead of A, the letter, and I know that that to the power of 0 is 1. And again, the power of algebra to generalize things we know about numbers. All right? So, let me tell you more things we can do with algebra, based on the things we can do with numbers, right? Because algebra is just generalized number stuff. So, say I gave you the numbers 12 add 4, what can you do? Well, you could add them, couldn't you? You could do 12 add 4. You could subtract them, 12 subtract 4. You could, multiply them. You could do 12 multiplied by 4. And you could divide them. You could do 12 divided by 4. Now, say I gave you X and Y, two numbers. We should be able to do the same things with them, right? So let's try and do that. If we add them, we would just do X add Y, like we did 12 add 4. If we subtracted them, we would do X subtract Y. If we multiplied them, now here's where maybe you got to think a little. You might think we get X multiplied by Y, but we don't write it like that. And can you ever think why and what might be wrong? Well, mathematicians do not bother writing this multiply sign here, because it looks like an X, and we use X a lot in algebra, so we would just write that as XY. And when you see XY, you know it's X multiplied by Y. That's really, really important. And when you divide them, Yeah, you could write x divided by y, but generally mathematicians have agreed not to write it like that. They write it in fraction form, x over y. Alright, so just these two, just bear in mind these two, because algebra tends to, uses them, and not so much, it doesn't use the multiply sign, and it rarely uses the divide sign. So that's pretty cool. What else could you do? Say with the number 12, I'd know, you could multiply it by 5. You could do 5 multiplied by 12. How would I do that with, let's say, x? Well, do you think I would write 5 multiplied by x? Nah. We've said we don't use the multiply sign. You would write 5x. So if you took x and multiplied it by 5, you get 5x. What if you did, let's do it the other way around. Let's say 12 multiplied by 5. Say you did, in the same case here, say you did x multiplied by 12. What do you think you'd write? Well, you could write, you're not allowed the time sign, so you might write x12, but it's sloppy. Mathematicians wouldn't write that. They would write 12x. Always write the number first. Okay, and other things you can do with numbers, let's say with 12 you can square it, that's how a mathematician squares it, or you could cube it, multiply it by itself 3 times. Similarly here, you would write x squared or you would write x cubed. And they're your basics of writing expressions. Now, an algebraic expression is something with letters in it and add signs, subtract, multiply and divide operations going on, but there's no equals here. These are just expressions because we haven't actually worked out any answer. So let's go and try some examples. Write the expression that results from each of the following series of steps. Now, we're going to start doing these using flowcharts just to help us understand what's going on, and they're going to be useful later to us in algebra, so we're going to persist with them, although you can see as we're going through this, you could probably start getting the answers without the flowchart, but just stick with me for now. Imagine you start with a number n. You double it. So a little flowchart there to say you double it. What do you get? Well, do you get n multiplied by 2? Do you get n2? Or do you get 2n? Do you remember which I said? You get 2n, that's right. So the answer to this would be 2n. That's the way a mathematician writes it. Next one. You start with y. And you subtract 4, and y take away 4, we just write as y subtract 4, like that. And the answer would be y subtract 4. Next, we're going to start with 10 this time, and we're going to subtract from it x. And the way a mathematician would write that is simply 10 subtract x, and our answer would be as simple as that. You start with p now, and you triple it. So you start with p. And to triple it means multiply it by 3. And how would you write that? P multiplied by 3? P3 or 3P? That's right, you're getting the hang of it, 3P. That's how a mathematician writes it. And this one here, it's important to spot the difference here. You start with P and you multiply it by itself 3 times. So you multiply it by itself once, what would you get? P times P is P squared. You multiply by itself again, and you would get p cubed. So you've taken p, you've times it by p, so it's been multiplied by itself twice, you times it by another p, it's been multiplied by itself 3 times, you would get yourself p cubed. And just notice the difference between 3p and p cubed. Students often get these confused. 3p means 3 multiplied by p, and p cubed means p multiplied by itself 3 times. Next one. Start with x, triple it, and subtract 3. Start with x, going to triple it, so multiply it by 3, and we get 3x, and then we've got to subtract 3 from that, so we're going to get the expression 3x subtract 3. And that's your answer. So we'll write it up here, 3x subtract 3. Okay, next question. Pause the video, have a go. Start with x, we're going to divide it by 3, so we're going to do divide it by 3. Remember how a mathematician writes that? X over 3, that's right. And then we're going to add 2 to that answer. So we're going to add 2. So we have x over 3 and then add 2. And there you go. That's all it is at this moment for introducing algebra to you and how to write simple expressions. Thanks for watching.